If you ever took chemistry, you've seen this, the periodic table. But maybe you weren't told where the elements came from. Hydrogen and helium are primordial. They were made in the first few minutes after the Big Bang. Lithium, beryllium, and boron are made by interstellar cosmic rays. But all the other natural elements are made by thermonuclear fusion reactions inside stars. That's where every atom in your body, except for the hydrogen, was made. Now, some helium is still being made by fusion of hydrogen in the cores of normal stars like the Sun. It's the source of the energy by which they shine. Only in the core of a star is the temperature high enough, about 10 million Celsius or more, for the positively charged protons to be moving fast enough to overcome their mutual electrical repulsion and fuse together. Late in its life, a star's core gets hot enough, about 100 million Celsius, for helium nuclei to fuse together into carbon. Helium fusing with carbon creates oxygen. That's where the carbon that is the basis of life's chemistry and the oxygen in the air that we breathe were born. The Ring Nebula is the remains of a low-mass star that shed its outer layers at the end of its life. Elements made in nuclear fusion by earlier generations of stars get returned to the interstellar medium of gas and dust in which later stars and planets are born. In the center of this image, you can see a white dwarf, which is the leftover, burnt-out carbon-oxygen core of the star that died. The Sun will itself leave behind a white dwarf when it dies more than 5 billion years from now. Now, only in very massive stars does the core ever get hot enough at the end of the star's life to create to have fusion of elements beyond helium, and eventually the core fills up with iron. When the mass of the iron core becomes too large, it collapses in milliseconds, releasing energy that blasts the outer layers off the star in a spectacular supernova explosion that gives off about as much energy as the Sun will give off during its entire 10 billion year lifetime. The Crab Nebula is the remains of a massive star that exploded in just this way. Now, elements that have more protons in them than iron are formed when nuclei capture neutrons that fly out of other nuclear reactions, and then further radioactive decays turn neutrons into protons. Now, one place that that happens is in low-mass stars at the end of their lives, for example, like, again, the star that made the Ring Nebula. But gold, like here in my ring, and platinum, and some other elements as well, need to be made in an environment that's much richer in neutrons. So it's actually, it turns out, not settled exactly where that happens. One possibility is in supernova explosions, but there's mounting evidence that the gold in the universe is mostly made by colliding neutron stars, boom, that collide with one another, and the neutron stars are super dense balls of neutrons that are left over when iron cores collapse. Either way, I think it's incredible to realize that that is the origin of bling. Meanwhile, most of the iron in the universe is created when white dwarfs explode after mass transfer from a companion star, or maybe a collision with a companion white dwarf, causes the temperature to exceed the 600 million Celsius needed to fuse carbon. After that happens, fusion of further elements occurs all the way up to the iron group. I think that it's absolutely amazing to realize that the iron in this weight and the iron in the hemoglobin that makes your blood red came from exploding white dwarfs billions of years ago. Thanks very much.